White boys fuck animals. White boys fuck animals, yeah. White boys fuck animals. White boys fuck animals, yeah.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to yet another sex weirdo degenerate stream. I'm your host, Dead Inside, and I'll be your... How you guys doing today? Excited for the hour-long intro, huh? I mean, I could do that. I could make you all suffer. Honestly, are you that eager to get to the Care of the Wolf stuff? Because... I've said it before, I'll say it again. This isn't going to be another, like, long snake thing one where we look at all the logs. He doesn't have that much to look at, honestly. But before we get to his YouTube channel, there's going to be quite a fair bit to say. Quite a fair few things to show. I understand there's still some people that like to suggest that this man didn't do what he did. So I'm going to put that to rest real the fuck fast. And, yeah. This is gonna be exciting. What's going on in chat? Kero is Japanese onomatopoeia for ribbit. Well, we know he likes to fuck snakes. Apparently. Allegedly. I don't even think that's alleged, but anyways. Keep Sonic CD soundtrack going. I mean, it just keeps you moving. Alright. So if you guys aren't familiar with Kero the Wolf, he is an individual who, should probably need no introduction if you've watched any of the other Zeusadist streams. He was kind of the main head honcho. I mean, he wasn't the head honcho, but he was like the big guy that everybody focused on. He was certainly not one of the more, depraved people in the group, But, I mean, that doesn't make him not a depraved person in and of itself. He's known for fucking dead foxes and his tiny puppy, which is very sad. Yes, and sadly the dog is now dead, so it doesn't even get a life without him. But, he's okay, though. He's not in jail or anything. He's a YouTuber, still on Patreon, everybody. I feel like that's worth mentioning. You know who's not on Patreon? Mr. Medicare. I think Dick Masterson got kicked off of Patreon. And Kero the Wolf's still on there? I don't know about that one. The Sangi of fair use, quick. Oh yeah, you're right. We do need a Sangi. I forgot the Sangi. However, we've also got a new friend on the stream, everybody. I hope you will welcome our new friend to go alongside the fair use Sangi. Sangi's new friend. Oh shit, is this the right one? I don't think this is the right one. God damn it, this is the fake PNG. I think I forgot to say, you know, no I didn't, hang on. We've got a Kero the Wolf fan club pin thing. I don't really know, but I think I saved the proper one somewhere. Oh damn! Did I not save that? Oh my god! I'm a failure of a human. Okay, I need to go. Well, shit. Okay, well we had a. Next time on the stream, we'll have a Kero the Wolf fan club sticker thing to go alongside Sangi. I'm sorry I riled you up, but I'm stupid and I forgot to save the good one. So thank you, Tex, or Alphabet in chat for making that. But, you know, next time it'll be good because there's just no end to the dog fuckers on this channel. But, yeah, so anyways, Kero the Wolf, not a... Thanks, Tex, but I have Discord closed on my computer because my internet's being fucking terrible today. So that's also a fair warning. But yeah, this isn't gonna be like another like super depressing stream like Snake Thing or something like that. I mean, we're not gonna be focusing on a lot of his logs. There are some things to read, as I said, but mostly we're gonna be taking a look at his wonderful YouTube channel, which still exists to this day. A little over 100,000 subs. YouTube hasn't removed it, obviously. He hasn't removed it. I'm sure he's probably deleted some videos, but the channel itself is still up. And we're going to be looking into that. We're going to be, taking a brief look at his Patreon. But, you know, before we get to any of that, I'm going to turn off the music here. And before we get to any of that, I am going to get some things up on screen here. So firstly, here is a picture that Kero uploaded to his Fur Affinity of his dog. Happy little pupper. 2011 this was taken. My puppy, oh so long ago. Well, he's all grown up now. He was really cute back then and still is too to this day. So happy, wonderful picture of the pupper. And, you guys are not, however, seeing the real juicy shack meat of this picture. It's actually the top one. Hello, I got a puppy and he is now 6 months old. The pictures below are when I first got him, but I was wondering, when can I have anal sex with him? He has a sexy butt. I don't want to harm him. So how old does he have to be ready for anal? Now, you might be wondering, well, what proof is this? Well, you know, take a nice long gander here. Kero Yamimura, I think is his name. And that's like his confirmed actual Fur Affinity account. Yeah, I don't know, guys. That's a striking resemblance. Oh, it even has the same time code down in the corner. Isn't that weird? Isn't it weird how Kero totally didn't do those things that he was accused of doing, though? Isn't that weird? So, yeah. Sadly, the dog died. I wish I could tell you that this was a happy ending, but it's not. I think this is the screenshot where he's talking with Snake Thing. Oh no, this is not the... I don't think I saved the right screenshot because there was one where he was talking about, oh, I just feel bad about raping my dog so many times now that he's developed kidney disease. And by the way, I wonder why he's developed kidney disease. It's not like there's any precious internal organs inside a dog, he was like feeling remorse or something. He was talking to, again, Snake Thing. Reminder that Snake Thing is a gentleman who we did an extensive stream on a couple months ago, who is now in prison for 25 years with no chance of parole. And let's be honest, he's not going to make it 25 years. Prisoners don't like sex weirdos. So, you know, at the very least, we've got some questionable stuff going on here. Again, this is just for all of the people who are still pretending that this man is innocent. Again, at the very least, we've got some very questionable associations going on here. I was thinking about leaving all zoo groups. It's a safety issue. Yeah, you wouldn't want to get caught fucking your dog in the ass, would you? That would be bad for your subscriber. You know, you don't want to post cringe, so... That makes sense. Here is this picture, which these were already kind of censored, but I decided to censor them a little extra because I'm not in the interest of showing dead foxes on this channel, but But if Kero was watching, I'm sure he would very much enjoy looking at this dead fox that he found. Or that a friend of his found, rather. He's sitting here talking to Snake Thing. Since you sent me stuff, I'll send you stuff. As always, this stays in the chat. Does not leave here. Yeah, it would be a shame for you in your career if nearly 2,000 people were watching this right now. That would really suck. Does not leave here. I promise that what you send me and what you have sent me before has stayed with me. What stuff you sending? And we've got... Now, this is, I believe... if I remember correctly, this is just like the... Oh, yeah, this is two images. That's right. One is like the fox with... a dead fox with him, like, spreading the ass open. And the other is the fox with its, like, mouth wide open. Which, of course... You know, as you can assume from seeing Roadkill, your first instinct would probably be to go, some fox, semicolon D. Oh, damn, oh, whoa, says Snake Thing. Where'd you get these, colon 3? Kero the Wolf, a friend found a dead fox. And here's another couple of images of his ass, which again I've extra blurred out. Like them? God damn, I do like them a lot. There's one more oral video with it. I'll send it for another oral vid. Not sure what other oral vid I have. Or any other dead wildlife works too. Famous Kero the Wolf quote. Any other dead wildlife works too. Or any other dead wildlife works too. Wonderful. Very good. Very Kino. So that's really all I really need to show you. There's a lot more proof of this. There's so much extensive evidence. A lot of it is not really all that related. The wonderful Archive the Wolf helped me out with a lot of this stuff. Sent me like 50 something fucking messages about Kero's bullshit and his like ex-boyfriend being a confirmed zoophile and his moderators being crazy and a lot of crazy shit. And I've decided not to show most of it because most of it's not really that related to the subject at hand. But it's out there. There's a lot of proof of this being very much true. And I just need you all to know that. So now that the introductory who is this guy segment can be completed, now it's time to move on, I believe, to some videos. Now, let me see here. I have to get the right thing opened here. That browser browsing. There you go. So this is Kero the Wolf's channel. Now, as you can see, 102,000 subs. Verified checkmarked account on YouTube, everybody. What do you guys think about that one? You think this guy should be a verified checkmarked account on YouTube? Bring us that Sangi. Yeah, so... Oh yeah, this is a wonderful thumbnail. I was really trying to find a version of this that was like bigger that I could use for the thumbnail for this stream, but sadly I was not successful. But I think the thumbnail worked out well enough. By the way, there's proof. There's additional proof that this is all real that ties to this video right here, where there's a log where. Kero says something about recording a video to Snake Thing, and he says, like, it's just this weird website where I derp around in a fursuit and look at some random websites, and he posted a screenshot of this, take me to a useless website, please, and, yeah, so that's just more extra proof that, you know, all of the accusations are true. Oh, by the way, everybody, this is a bully stream. Let's get into this video. Welcome to his channel, everybody.
Kero. Hi, I'm Kero.
Hi.
And I'm not your average YouTuber.
No, not every YouTuber fucks roadkill. You're right. You've really got that edge.
Do things a little bit different.
We like to do things a little different around here. Oh. Oh, look at all these vomit costumes. Oh, wow. Oh, it's so exciting. Adam from YMS. Oh, wow, you went down a 5-foot slope. You're so cool. Friendly reminder that everybody filmed in these videos is an accomplice. And you'll have to show me proof. You know what? This is guilty until proven innocent. Fuck you. You're all accomplices until you prove me otherwise. How old do you think that girl was in that Omegle thing there? I don't know if I like that one. Keeps getting worse, bro. Pigs in a blanket, your favorite. AKA your sex life.
Weirded out? Confused? Good. If you like what you see, make sure to hit that subscribe button.
Oh yeah, you guys gonna subscribble? Remember to like and subscribble. So before we get further into this, I want to show another thing here, which I shocked and depressed myself with earlier, as well as my Discord and all of Twitter. By the way, my internet is being fucking terrible today. So if pages take forever to open, well, that's just a matter of course, I guess. But yeah, Kero the Wolf, if this will ever fucking load, is still on Patreon. And we're gonna see here. My God, hurry up! Oh my God. This is stupid. Oh my God. I think it's time, between the internet fucking up and the Kero the Wolf and the fact that it's currently 10 a.m., I think it's time to start drinking. I think that's acceptable. I haven't had one in a few days. I think it's acceptable. Hey, here we are on patreon.com/KeroTheWolf. He's creating YouTube videos, everybody. You can be the basic role. You can see his Patreon feed. $5 a month, you can be the super role, get access to his private live stream exclusively for his patrons. And then $10, you get his Discord. Isn't that so awesome? You get to join his Discord for $10 a month and talk to our boy here. That's so cool. He's got 27 patrons. Oh, there's 6 more. Oh, my. Okay, there's the Kero role for $25. If you choose to support me with $25... you'll be in my... By the way, the dollar sign is in the wrong place, you dumb fuck. You'll get to be in my video, introduce my channel. If the intro and outro is filled, everyone will take turns. You'll also get access to... Yeah, I'm sure you're very experienced, you and your furry buddies, with everybody getting to take turns if something is filled. The talking role, $35 a month. To those who select this tier, thank you. I will have a personal Google Hangouts call with you once a month. For 20 minutes to an hour. Isn't that such a delight? Isn't that just such a delight for that person? Also, up to 2 times a month, you can request a simple voice message or a video message from me, and I will record them and edit them for you. You can use them how you please. Keep all requests PG. You'll also get all previous rewards, too. And then finally, $50. Up to 2 times a month, I will let you decide what I make for my YouTube videos. 2 videos a month. They can be anything you want them to be about, and I will do it! So does anybody want to give this guy $50 a month so he'll be obligated to make a YouTube video talking about how he fucks dogs? That would be kind of fun. But yeah, he's still on Patreon. Again, reminder that... Oh, he's posted some stuff recently, too. Isn't that so cool? He's still active on Patreon, no less. Yeah, reminder that Mr. Mediker got kicked off of Patreon. That's pretty cool. I guess it's okay if you think wrong, as long it's not okay, rather, if you think wrong. It's only okay if you think right and happen to have your dick in a puppy. That's fine. That's fine, according to Patreon. So, yeah, I mean, that's cool. That's super cool. Just wanted to let y'all know about that. Merry Christmas. Oh, whoa. Still very active on Patreon. Still around. In fact, he's more active than me, which is saying something. I'll get to that Saint Anger listen along pretty soon. I said I was going to record it a little while ago, and then I realized I wasn't getting drunk that night. So maybe after the stream. I don't know, but... Yes, he's very active on Patreon. He just makes you really think some things. It's very interesting. It's very interesting. So, you know, let's get back into the Kero the Wolf channel. Let's see the most recent video, I think, is this one, Emotion. And ironically, the one next to it is How to Become a Meme. Well, you know, there's probably better ways than the way you went about it, fucko. But you did it. You did it. Let's check out Emotion. I guess this is his sad apology video. This is the only apology video where having a dog for sympathy will actually not work. Let's watch.
Life isn't always easy.
Yeah, not for that dog you fucking raped to death. So is this where we're gonna find the bodies, Carol?
No one knows what tomorrow will bring. Today's struggles...
The coom all over that tree?
Disaster.
Today's struggles can become tomorrow's disaster. If only his dog would have just stopped struggling, it would have all gone so much easier.
We don't get to choose how our lives play out.
As a side note, are you fucking kidding me with this video right now, my dude?
Sometimes it feels like things happen for us beyond our control. It's like a roller coaster.
You're trying to hide your zoophilia. You think everything's square. Snake Thing says he's gonna keep mom. But then there's like leaks and suddenly people are calling you out and you have to pretend there's Iranian super hackers and shit. It's crazy, bro. Words. Inspirational. This is like a Prince EA video.
Things change every day for the better or worse. Like how fall turns to winter. Even though things may be bad right now, I still have hope for the future.
Yeah, what's the deal with all of these people having the same voice?
They all kind of sound like this. They all have this, like, soy-filled bitch voice. They never really grew out of being, like, a 14-year-old.
It's like Onision, this guy, fucking Sangi, every single one of them. Jesus.
I'm hurt, yes. But I will keep moving forward.
Can we listen to that again, real quick?
But I will keep moving forward.
What was that?
I still have hope for the future.
You have hope for the future, yeah?
I'm hurt, yes.
He's hurt, everybody. But he's gonna keep moving forward. I guess that dog's asshole was a little tighter than he had anticipated, but by God, once he sets his mind to something...
But I will keep moving forward.
I heard my dog today. Thank you, chat member. I think this is officially the worst apology video I've ever seen. Congrats. This is worse than, like... This is worse than, like, T. Martin. This is worse than that bitch fake crying. with the makeup scandal. This is worse than fucking J-Station crying from his eyebrows. Good job, Kero. You did it. You won the Being a Little Bitch Award.
You don't have to be a winner if you give it your best. Believe in who you are, and then time will do the rest.
You don't have to be a winner if you give your best. Believe in who you are. And hopefully, the law will do the rest. So there's the apology video. It's not even an apology. That's not even an apology. That's like, yeah, I didn't do it, and you're all wrong. By the way, shout-outs to Archive the Wolf over here with all sorts of actual good info about all of the proof that this guy is. Wow. Oh, my God. Hey, guys. Guess who weeds out his comments section? I'm glad Kero's coming back. I knew deep down he didn't do anything and people were just trolling. The thing about the internet is that UA rumor can spread like wildfire, and the fact that he was a furry didn't help, since anti-furs... Just gotta do a thing real quick. Don't mind me. I'm just getting this. There you go. There you go. And then hang on. We need to. There you go. Okay. Okay, good. Okay, we're good. What was I reading? Oh, yeah. Anti-furs would latch on to that to push their own bias, false beliefs, which was only made worse by the fact that people believed them, creating a mob mentality. When I first watched the video, I was very sad to see Kero go, and all because of a stupid witch hunt. I can get the people that followed the crowd thinking that he was guilt. Hang on, hold on. I just need to. Is this the one? I think this is the one. Actually, this is the one. I just need to. There you go. That's good. There you go. Okay. Get the people following the crowd thinking that he was guilty. I mean, it's basic psychology to want to conform with the crowd, but holy shit, this is long. But at the same time, I'm angered by the blind fury that some people got into without even know the full story. I remember going on social media right after I found out about the rumor. There were hate posts and chains of comments. I'm trying to find the best place for this, but anyways... I think that's enough of that. Yeah, it's just a witch hunt, guys. It's just totally bogus. Totally bogus witch hunt. Need more Kero live streams. Running low on adorableness. I will always support Kero. This is from a day ago. What's this fucker's channel look like? Because I know he's innocent. No ignorant YouTuber that jumps on the hate train without doing research into the situation will convince me otherwise. Well, good for you, person, because I am an ignorant YouTuber that did do some research into the situation. There you go. How about that? How about them? How about Thos Beans? There are so many videos that just made up stuff for clicks and views because Kero is popular, and that equals sweet, sweet ad revenue. Yeah. Yeah, zoophilia is a really trending ad revenue subject. Yeah. Or just did a little research and came to a conclusion from that. I'll leave the... Yeah, a little research into the proof that there is, and that's all you really fucking need, but there's a lot. Oh my god, Snake Thing is in jail. This isn't right. He didn't send those vids. He's a good guy. We need to prove that the people who put him there are wrong. View 8 replies. By the way, this guy is a crazy motherfucker as well. This voice of truth, crazy motherfucker. I'm curious, what happened to Kero? Hey, Kero, remember me? That opening is flawless, says this person. Last night I joined the $5 super roll tier on Patreon, Kero. I know you're going through hard times, and I want to help. Yeah, it's just so hard when you fucked your dog in the ass until it had kidney problems. That's just so hard for you. That's really, you know, that's just, you know, honestly, that's just, that comes with the YouTuber lifestyle, honestly. So let's take a look at some more videos here, from better times in this, this guy's life. Let's look at, you don't need a fursuit. Can you be straight? Well, probably not you. Unbox YouTube play button unboxing. They gave him a YouTube play button, everybody. YouTube sent out a play button to this man. Let's see him unbox his play button, everybody. This is exciting. Come the fuck on. Load my goddamn video. Why is my internet like this, you whore? I'm not even drunk yet.
Okay, this is about to be epic.
Hey guys, so this is just a really quick thing. I got something in the mail today, and I wanted to unbox it for all of you, because you guys...
Why are his eyes following me? Holy shit, that's disturbing.
Got me this far, and I think we should all experience
this. It's like they're following me. I don't like this.
Together. So, let's get started. I got something from YouTube! Oh my god! Now, with all big things, of course, we need a big knife. So let's start it.
Yeah, that's your experience with all the Great Danes on your block, anyway.
Okay.
You know, if we thought about this ahead of time, we probably would have, like, at least undid the
tail. We should have did that.
It's okay.
Yeah, blade away from your face. Always good. Okay.
Don't forget to wear a helmet.
Hey, remember not to be too careful with that blade there, what's the saying? Cross the road, not down the street. I don't remember.
We don't have a helmet. God damn it. Oh well. We'll get the helmet next time at a million. Where? Oh, the bottom. Oh, okay, I see it. Okay.
We're professionals.
No!
Unless you didn't cut, like, one side.
God damn it. No!
What have you done?
It's black! Wow!
Get it, everybody.
Alright. Oh, there's a letter! It's done something that a few YouTuber creators accomplished. You just accomplished 100,000 people subscribed to your channel. We know that numbers on YouTube can get really big, but we hope that you don't lose sight of reality behind the six-digit milestone. Each and every person who has subscribed to your channel has been touched by what you created. They were inspired.
Especially the dogs.
Challenged or entertained. You achieved the milestone with hard work, perseverance, and probably a healthy sense of humor. Ain't that true? Boy, what you accomplished can't be taken away from you, and we'd like to recognize you.
So you know what sucks is I'm probably going to get one of these stupid play buttons pretty soon, and boy, is that going to be less of a fun experience now. I'm just going to be thinking about this motherfucker in his Hakuna Matata shirt.
With all your hard work with this Silver Creator Award, a small token of our esteem and respect. We know that you don't do this for rewards. You do it because you have to drive, to create and share, and because you found an audience who cares. Believe us, when we say that we can't wait to see what you do next, a million subscribers may seem a long way off right now, but you're closer than you think. We're rooting for you, congrats. Yours sincerely, Susan Wahak. Wow. How do you say her name? Is it Wahak?
Thank you, Susan, once again. Susan specifically has signed off on this one. So let's take a look at... What do we got here? How to become a meme.
Today I'm gonna be showing you how to become a meme. First.
Well, you already did that one, so how about you show me how to become a cadaver?
First thing you gotta do is green screen yourself into everything. Like music videos.
Don't you ever just wish you could have wound up like Kero's dog?
Word of my visions reach the church, and I was asked...
Oh, this is like a copyright claim extravaganza right here. Thanks, bro. Can't wait for this. It's like somebody booby-trapping their own content, so if anybody ever makes fun of their fucking dog fucker ass, they can just be like, yeah, well, fuck you. Your stream's now owned by UMG and HMO and HBO and WHO and fuck.
Video. I'm trying to do videos like I did in college, so this is kind of similar to what I was doing.
You know, that was in your heyday, bro. That was back when you were fucking like 3 dogs a day. I mean, now it's you slowed down so much in your old age, you know. Let's see. I don't drink, but after watching enough furry fucking zoophile videos, you probably will learn to. Kero 3.0 unboxing. Yeah, apparently Shane Dawson had this guy in one of his fucking videos. I guess we should watch this. Didn't he take down the video after it turned out that this guy fucks dogs and roadkill? Didn't that happen? So.
Hello, my name's Tyler Furlong, and welcome to this week's video.
Hey guys, so today we're going to do something a little bit different. Normally I don't do-
Imagine what it must feel like to have had a part in this. Like, looking back on, you know, like, that's gotta be a great- Maybe that guy also rapes puppies, so, I mean, you know.
React videos, but today's pretty special. As a lot of you know, probably, I did an interview with Shane Dawson. I'm really nervous, but really excited, so let's get to it. Oh, God.
Well, this officially makes this the second worst thing Shane Dawson's ever done.
Thumbnail. Oh, Jesus. I mean, hey, it's a great thumbnail.
I guess, to be fair, Shane Dawson and Kero have a lot in common. They both fuck animals.
Go.
This is a joke. This is a joke. He didn't fuck his cat. Stop with that meme.
The weird side of the internet.
Even though I just made the meme.
We're going to be talking about furries. Now, if you don't know what a furry is, basically it's a person who wears...
Hey, every 12-year-old white girl, do you not know what a furry is? Well, I guess you're going to know now.
An animal
Thanks,
suit,
Shane.
And they take on a fursona. And some people like to have sex
fursona.
In the suit, some people don't. Me personally, like, that's the first thing I would do. But I found a furry on the internet named Kero the Wolf, and he has a YouTube channel, and we're gonna go in.
The authority on you understand how it's a little difficult for me to buy this sort of like, but not all furries, but most of them are good. I know some of them are good. I'm gonna suggest it might be a fucking smaller minority than we might have thought, though, because when you realize it's a little difficult for me to believe that this is not all furries, as the hashtag would state, when this is like the ambassador of furries. On YouTube, anyway. Like, this guy, I don't know. This guy's pretty well known. A lot of fucking people still follow him. He still has over 100,000 subscribers, and he's still making money on Patreon. So, I don't know, man. You just, it's a little hard for me to believe sometimes. I don't know.
Hey, I got some big news.
Maybe he represents furries on this. Maybe Kero is actually the perfect guy for Shane to have interviewed. Maybe he represents furries too well.
Sorry, that was a lot.
Is he already crying? This fucking soy-filled bitch tits.
Not that video. No.
That was like.
Okay, so that video, I was just moving out of my dorms, and I was moving. I just wanted to give an update. So this was basically, hey, ask me questions, I'm moving out, I'll be in a new apartment, I want to do a Q&A because I hit 8,000 subscribers, and stuff like that. I didn't know he would choose this one, because it's a little cringy, but...
It's a furry video, you're in a fursuit. I don't think there's an op... I don't think it's a sliding scale at that point. I think it's a pretty binary, either fursuit, cringy, or not in fursuit, normal human being.
Okay, I'm gonna keep going.
Can we get like a gif of him like shaking like that? That's so sexy. I just want to mur to it all.
I'm gonna keep going. And go.
Joey with a big animal head.
This is kind of like a life update video because a lot of things are just happening currently. So this.
I'm on whatever he's on.
But it's okay. It's gonna be a new location, new sites, new awesome people, and
It's gonna be awesome.
Does he shit in that? Like, remember the baby diaper girl? Like, she probably shit in the diaper.
So I don't do that!
Shit outside? Like a wolf? I thought his neighbor's just like...
Alright, guys, at least he doesn't shit in the fursuit. He just, he just fucks dogs while he's in the fursuit. Shitting in it would be gross, though.
Kero. Oh. Also, or his neighbor's like, don't shit on my lawn! I already love him.
Second thing, I just hit 8,000 subscribers! Thank you guys so much!
He deserves a lot more than that. Guys, please vote Kero.
He really does, doesn't he? Doesn't he, Shane?
Kero, if we get you to 100K, can I fuck you in that suit?
No. Really? No.
Well, he's over 100K now, Shane. I mean, I assume the offer still stands.
How about a hug? A hug works better.
I don't care. But you're probably wondering why I'm so entertained today. And it's as well as anything. I don't
want to sugar.
I think I drank like 2 bottles and it's
really tough.
Anyway.
I want that on top of me. I want to lay there. And I want him to...
Guys, do we need to start asking questions about Shane again? Because I was certain he didn't fuck his cat, but now...
Hack me. I want him to rip my throat out.
No, why?
Boy, now I'm fucking realizing why he took this video down.
Jeez. Okay.
This is turning into a bigger Shane bully stream than anything.
I have stubs. I don't really have a lot of teeth.
Today I found this really cool website and I wanted to show it to all of you guys.
Is this sponsored? Kero, no. How are you getting more brand deals than me?
I'm not!
How is he, actually? That's a good question.
Oh no, not that. No! Okay, that video I did for my motion graphics class, because YOLO, and it was really fun.
Is that how he sees himself?
No.
By the way, yes, guys, I realize we're currently doing a reaction to a reaction to a reaction. This is what YouTube is now. It's 2020, motherfuckers. Toot toot. This is the train. There's no stopping it. This motherfucker runs up to you in a dark alley one night, and all you see are like the white parts because it's like dark, and it's like, is that not pants shitting fright right then and there? That's worse than anything in LSD.
That one is making me feel some type of way, and that way is scary.
I'm sorry, Sebastian. He's scared of you.
Of course he knows who this is.
Okay. I'm not dead yet. Okay, here we go.
I don't trust no one. Like, he's cute, but he'll fuck you up. See, it's the head twitches. It's the... Like, I don't trust that. Like, not just birds, like people in general. Like, when I'm at Walmart...
Yeah, well, I don't know, Shane. Your ability to trust people is certainly under deep consideration at this point.
Alright, somebody walks by me and they're like... I'm like, you stay in your lane, honey, and I'll stay in my lane, the hostess lane. What? Did he just say smelt my finger to her? See, I told you I did not trust him!
Oh my god.
Am I gonna cry right now?
Yes, you're gonna cry.
Also that kid with the camera.
Of course you are, you're Shane Dawson. Alright, well now we're just making fun of Shane more than anything, so let's get back to the show at hand here, and let's find some... Well, first of all, let's take a look at the community tab here, where he still posts semi-frequently. Hey guys, Merry Christmas. I hope everyone's having an amazing time with they are families. Since it's Christmas... I'll give you some background info on my first Wolf in the Woods video. Oh boy, I'm so excited. It was a concept I always wanted to do. Make my own original story. I got the idea from Parks and Recreation, the TV show. I love how they break the rules of camera angles to have a more comedic effect. I wanted it to have a movie opening, so have it super cinematic, then cut to me being weird. So just a sudden slam cut to you balls deep in your pupper. All right, that's cool. 4 months ago, hey guys, been a while since I posted here, since Halloween is near, and you know there's nothing scarier than myself, Kero the Wolf. I thought I'd reshare this video. This is one of my favorite Halloween videos I've made. Also, I wanted to give some backstory about the video, blah blah blah, nobody gives a fuck. But we know how much you love your dog's backstory. Let's look at videos again. Here's Kero coming at you with a fucking knife. Run, motherfuckers. Jesus Christ. What have we become? Load my fucking video, god damn it!
Hello? My name's Tyler Furlong.
Who is this fucker, and why does he have a Nightwish poster in the background? Stop! Stop ruining things I like!
Welcome to this week's video!
Oh, is that his BF, the other confirmed zoophile? That's cool. I heard something about he had some kind of fundraiser up for his boyfriend without telling people that his boyfriend was secretly fucking dogs or something like that. I remember there was some level of deceit to this, like, fundraiser that he had for his sick, ailing boyfriend, which, I mean, you know, that's unfortunate, but if he's fucking animals, I don't know. I don't know if that's the boyfriend. It's just what someone in chat said.
Kero shorts.
I didn't say I like modern Nightwish. I said I like Nightwish. I like a Ned-era Nightwish. Shut up. Shut up! I like Epica too! What are you gonna do about it, fucker? Well, we've got some beauty going on right now.
Like the bees to the flowers, so is Kero's cock to his schnauzer.
Hi guys, Kero here. Last time we talked, I taught you how to survive in the extreme cold. You also met my roommate, Phil. Fuck you.
I really would have preferred if that video went wrong.
Yeah, thank you, Phil. Good job. Fuck you. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to survive in the wilderness. If your busty answer kind of dropped you off at the
Again, if you just happen to fail at surviving in this video, that's fine. I mean, that's also fine. It could turn into a what not to do, you know. That footage is still salvageable. It might not be on YouTube, but I mean, your dog raping ass still is, so I mean, it's probably not a problem.
Wrong stop, and you're stuck in a spooky forest. You need to be prepared. You gotta be prepared. So I'm gonna teach you how to survive in the woods and-
Yeah, Kero seems really fucking familiar with this forest. We keep seeing Kero in this fucking forest in all these videos. In that stupid fucking emotion video. He was like, emotional in the fucking forest. And all these shots of the forest with his drone or whatever the fuck he got. Maybe it was just stock footage, I don't know. But he sure seems to like the forest. I made the joke earlier that it's where he hides his fucking victims. But I mean, how much of a joke can we be? We know he fucks roadkill, so I mean, anything's possible.
Two easy steps. First thing you gotta do is find some shelter. If you can't find any caves nearby, then oh, you're in luck. Because we could build one. It's called a teepee. All you gotta do is just throw sticks at a tree, and then it kinda just builds itself. See? Kinda like that. Now, it's gonna be nighttime soon, so what do you gotta do? You gotta climb in your newly built teepee that you worked so hard on. Don't get me started. It was so nice. And then what you do, you reach behind that little tree stump and...
So now I'm just imagining a video exactly like this, but it's Kero in full fursuit going all, "Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're we're gonna teach you how to rape a dog. So first you gotta go behind the dog, and you gotta lift up the tail, and then you gotta just get right in there, guys. Oh, whoa! And then he edits in like a meme.
Hello?
Also, I pressed my jabroni mouse button and I exited the video, but it's fine. We're gonna skip ahead anyway. Woo! Oh, there he goes, down the fucking waterfall with no paddle. Rest in peace, Kero the Wolf. You won't be missed.
Yeah, boy, go!
But that's okay, because now you got water. It's so good. You can swim around, you can drink it. Oh, it's gonna be so delicious. Now, it's time to go get some food. So here's what you do.
Go
you take
get
out
some
the sword
poon?
That you forge
that?
From the bones of your enemies, and then you just stab the ground and the earth will give you food. Okay. Oh yeah. Ooh, an apple, cool. Wow. Ah, no.
Point the sword at yourself, you fuck.
All right. Works. Huh.
Now we just need to know if the bigger crime here is his fucking transgressions against dogs or his transgressions against, well, humanity itself, or his transgressions against fucking comedy.
Let's try the big sword. All right. Let's do this. Okay. What is this?
Well, you were busy studying the ways of not fucking animals. I was busy studying the blade.
Fuck you, love, Phil. What? No, wait, Phil! Really? Come on! God damn it! But don't stab it too much or the earth will get mad at you. Now at this point, we're really surviving out here. We're flourishing. We got the waters. We got the food.
Don't worry, Kero. I think the earth is already mad at you.
We got the place. Boy, you're living now. Boy. And that, kids, is how you survive.
Boy. Just the age Kero likes him. Actually, there's no proof of that. But, I mean, he was in close contact with snake things. So, are we really going to put that past him?
Live in the wilderness. Dude, man, I got a sword. Wow. Actually, I got two swords. Whee! Ah. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching this mini short. If you liked the video, give it a big thumbs up. If you disliked it, give it a thumbs down.
Yeah, let's just give it a thumbs down. Ah, fuck, I'm not logged in. I was going to do it. But, yeah, okay. That's the thing. By the way, another thing to point out is that the cops wound up not arresting Kero. And I would like to say there seems to be some very large issues with the legal system in a number of countries where I guess they've completely fucking they have this blind spot for like zoophilia crimes because in Cuba they don't have a law against that, so woof, dealing with him was a problem. And apparently snake thing, despite all of the evidence of what he did to animals, he only got arrested. He only got charged on his counts of like child pornography and shit like that. So there's a lot of people like Sangi too, despite what happened. Well, that was with kids, but I mean, even still, you know, there's some serious problems here where you can apparently have perfectly 100% attributable quotes to a person, and yet. Apparently that's not enough. You can have mountains of evidence, but somehow that's not enough. And I guess some places just don't even have a law against raping your own dog. So, like, there's probably, like, for all we know, there his police jurisdiction was just like, well, shit, we've never had someone this much of a fucking sick sex weirdo before. So we don't actually have a law made for him yet. Because that's basically what it was with Cuba. There was nobody in Cuba who was a sicker motherfucker than Wolf, and they didn't have laws prepared for him. So So I feel like the police should fucking take notes. If there's anybody from the goddamn police force watching these streams, take some fucking notes, because you people need to... I don't know. I guess the police don't set the laws, but the government does. I don't know. Something's got to give. You got to be able to crack down more on people who are like confirmed dog fuckers and rapists. Let's move on. We're going to do, oh God, this one's 16 minutes. Holy shit. No, thank you. We're going to do one more and then I'm going to get into some, super chats and then we're going to continue with his terrible YouTube. But, let's do one more for now. Don't say hi. My food is better. The wolf's den. This is going back now. Let's find one of his older videos. Cause reminder of some timestamps real quick. If you think that this is all just, like, new drama or something, reminder that, and we saw this before, but I'll show it again, this picture, him on this Beast forum, was in 2012. So he's been doing this for quite some time. So when you see these videos and they're dated, like, 3 years ago, 2 years ago, whatever, this is still all 100% relevant to the situation at hand, because this fucker... here's his pet peeves, everybody. Insert joke about pets here. I'm not even going to make one. Let's watch this one. You know what really grinds my gears? People who fuck dogs. What's that all about? Come on, video. Load. I need to get my fix of disgusting scum, please. Please, video, load. I will sacrifice my unborn child to you. I will sacrifice my broken lava lamp to you.
We all have that one thing that drives us absolutely insane. And it makes us want to be so in the face of the fish. Ah! But guess what? I don't have a fish.
Wow, how were his videos worse before? Also, guess what? He doesn't have a fish. Not anymore, at least.
About my top pet peeves that I have. Because I don't have no life right now, and yay. Okay, so does this ever happen to you? You're walking in the grocery store or your house, and then a person randomly flashes behind you and then punches you in the face with a giant overly sized boxing glove. Ah!
Oh my God, I fucking wish I was dead.
I absolutely hate that. Now I know a lot of you have had this problem before. Bad conversation starters. Say you're in instant messaging, you know, Facebook Messenger or whatever you're on. You're just typing away. Just typing, you know, you're having a good time.
Just new boot typing.
You're sipping on some tea and this pops up. So for a conversation starter, when you message someone, have a topic ready. That is like the most important thing if you ever want to talk to someone.
So how about that dog's anus the other night? Am I right, bro? Wasn't that crazy?
Don't just say hi. Say, hey, I'm a fan of your work. I had a question regarding blah, 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 or...
Why is he like... I hate it when people fucking film in front of a green screen and they don't key anything into the fucking green screen. Like, why do you even have a goddamn green screen? Film in front of a white fucking wall. What is wrong with you?
You don't have to be
wait, it's the rabies from raping dead animals.
Out of them at all.
I guess it's not rape if they're dead, so never mind.
You just say, hey, what's your favorite milk carton? I don't know. I didn't write a script, as you can tell. I'm going off the pill per se. So yeah, you can say, hey, what's your favorite milk carton? Then they'll be like, oh, that's a weird question. I don't know.
Oh,
this is my favorite milk carton.
What the and fuck so are I still fourth and retard, holy shit.
Keep asking interesting questions. And my fourth and final one, this one drives me absolutely insane. And this goes directly out to the fursuiters.
When you've got a dog and I offer to fuck your dog, and you won't even do me the courtesy of letting me fuck your dog. Like what's up with the what is that all about, man?
For the final pet peeve, it's fursuiters who treat non-fursuiters like poop.
I only hang out with fursuiters.
God,
we're all
mess.
Adorable. Besides you, go away.
I mean, seriously, come on, guys. Really? Really? Why? Why?
Reminder that I might make jokes about YMS, and I know the chat's saying some stuff, but I actually do genuinely like his videos, so it's a little bit of a shame that he's got some interesting opinions about bestiality, but you know, I mean, I don't know. It's nothing confirmed yet. I can at least still watch him give 6 out of 10 and not think about it.
First of all, you have no right to be mean to a person who doesn't have a fursuit, okay? They don't have enough money, or they're not fortunate enough to have the money to go out and spend $4,000 on a very expensive... oh my god, excuse my English. They don't have enough money to go out and spend...
It's okay, dude, you're an animal. You're not... There's no expectations.
On a wearable rug, okay? That's basically what this is. You sweat in it, you roll around in the dirt, and you may fall on it a few times. It's a rug.
Wearable rug. That's a good way of describing it, I guess. It's like wearing a dead bear rug, but all over your fucking face.
Or a couch. It could be a couch. I'm just saying. Non-suitors, hey, the person could be the most awesome person in the world, but you don't care. Because...
Yeah, he could have like a whole kennel of dogs that he fucks. Just because he doesn't own a fursuit doesn't mean he's a bad person. Come on.
I'm wearing a fursuit and I'm more important than everyone else. That's basically the attitude you're putting on them. And it's horrible. I can't stand it. Like, even in the Vine community, I you know, they know me from Vine. Like, some people refuse to do Vine, like, Vines with, like, people who don't have fursuits. And that just drives me insane. They're like, oh, why won't you do a Vine with them? They don't have a fursuit, and it would gain much attention. I'm like, wow, that's not the point. You're fursuiting to entertain people, not to bring them down. Okay, we're part of a community that likes to entertain people and make them happy. You're going completely against that. Anyway, sorry for my rant. Those are my 4 absolutely huge pet peeves.
They like to entertain people, everybody. They're just like clowns. They're like furry clowns. That's exactly what a furry is. I wonder what clowns rape. Anyways.
Of all time. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm gonna try my best to make more.
How do his eyes move like that, says chat member. Yeah, I don't know. I think Aiden Paladin had some suggestions. I think she said it was like convex or concave. I'm not sure which one, but apparently it's the same technique that like they used for Mona Lisa or something. I don't know. So this is an art fursuit, everybody. But that's the pet peeve video. I am going to read off some super chats for a little bit here, but we are going to get back to the YouTube channel, so just sit tight. Let's see what we got here. Oh god, I have to catch up. 5,000W with 2 lines through it from T. Kim. I need to learn what these fucking currencies are, goddammit. From T. Kim, yes, finally one for the night shift. ZZZZZZ with $5. Daddy Banjo Claw, are you turning into a furry? Because Bully Streams targeting problematic furries is extremely furry. We do it all the time. Well, first of all, please never use the word problematic in my chat again. But secondly, no. If anything, this is eroding my limited sympathy that I once had. But hang on, let's get some good tunes going here while I do this. There you go. $3 from Fidgety Penguin. I go to work in 30 minutes, you dork! Have a good day. Well, I have a good day at work, sir. I hope you have fun. $2 from Mew Ichigo. Please tell me this one got life in jail, no parole. No, this one's still free. Technically, his crimes aren't as bad as Snake Thing or any of them, but I mean... Even still, I don't know. 10 euros from Bloodmark Mentor. Obligatory, unprecedented, excessive, inhumane violence statement for another sex weirdo stream. $10 because I missed the Sangi stream. Well, thank you. I hope you have fun with this one. 10 pounds from Job Richardson. Well, this is going to be a horrible experience. Thank you for providing this content, though. Hope you're doing well. I am doing fairly well. I hope you're doing well. And thank you. I hope you enjoy yourself today. $5 is from... That's cool. Just freeze my music for a second. That's awesome. $5 from Nick the Struggle Snuggler. Remember, no bully. Oh no, this is absolutely bully stream. Fuck this cunt. $2 from Nuzzles. Impregnate the fox corpse, daddy qua. Oh whoa. Thank you, Nuzzles. Very cool. $5 from Cooper Stevenson. From the fur fags in the sicko army, we absolutely hate this subhuman shit stain. Bully him good, Clawfather. I know there's some of you who are okay, so, I mean, just don't go to school tomorrow. But no, I mean, I know some of you are alright, so I'm not blank. It's not a blanket statement to every furry, but it's like, ugh. General sidelong stare to furries, so, you know, that's not your fault, but, ugh. $5 from Mark Mendez. Speaking of sex weirdos, you ever plan on doing a Yandere dev stream? Probably not. I don't know. It's not that interesting to me. I am familiar with him from back in the day when he would post on V, though. So, I mean, I guess there is a tiny bit of, like, perspective there, but I don't know. I never really cared. I know he's a bit of an asshole, though. So, I mean, might be interesting. There's a lot of videos about him, though, so I don't know. £5 from Joe Cameron. Sex weirdo streams are the best thing to listen to while I play Minecraft. Love you, Papa Claw. Well, you know, Minecraft feels like it would be a game that goes well with sex weirdos, so, you know, that sounds about right. I hope you have fun. $2 from Artemis. Glad to see you roast this guy. Take care, Claw. Oh, thank you. I hope that I am taking somewhat care, but, you know, you can never be sure. Reminder that Kero's got some crazy moderators who, like, show up and start spamming you with paragraphs of, oh, whoa, Nuzzles you, but it's not ironic. So that could happen. That could be fun. Let's see. $5 from Lukewarm Coffee. Met Kero on Omegle 2 times. Didn't know he did that to animals then. My conversation would have been different. Jeez. Sorry to you, Lukewarm Coffee. But, I mean, you know, I guess that could be true of anybody you meet. There's got to be some kind of screening process for these people. If only there was, like, a litmus test we could come up with. Maybe show them, like, maybe just straight up show them some animal torture and see if they're like, what the fuck is wrong with you? And then if they are, you can be like, okay, good, you're not a sex weirdo. They'll probably think you're a sex weirdo, but I mean, I don't know. $5 from Garu Popka. Pee pee poo poo stream when? We need animated James. Also, Toilet Vore Squad, where you at? Shameless plug for my East 621 tags. Boy, it's a good thing you're giving me money. Otherwise, I would have banned you. But thank you. $5 from $5 from Danny Devoid. Have you ever been mistaken for a bear furry who roleplays as Banjo? Because that'd be really unfortunate. Yes. Yes, that's happened. Not surprisingly. You know, there was a point there when I was considering changing my picture from Banjo to something else, because people were getting the wrong idea. But then I was just like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm dying on this hill. I like Banjo-Kazooie. Go fuck yourself. 2000W with 2 lines through it. I hate that I have to call it that. From T-Kim. Please make a ooh-woo merch. Well, I'll make some merch, potentially, but not ooh-woo merch. No thank you. Hey, Deadwing, would you be willing to do some classic PS1 game streams like Gex, Spyro, Crash Bandicoot, or Sly Cooper, Ratchet and Clank? I mean, those are all good choices, so, you know, props to you. I might play some Gex on stream sometime. I don't tend to play, unless they're, like, really special to me, like the game Bully or, like, a Yakuza game. I don't really tend to play good stuff on the channel. I mean, maybe I might. I don't want to infringe on Vinny's territory too much. I already steal all his memes. I don't need to steal his content. But I have been thinking about maybe streaming, like, I don't know. I know he's been doing Besiege recently, but I've been thinking about streaming that. And maybe some other stuff. I don't know. I got a lot of stuff I might stream now. Maybe I'll do some Lego Worlds someday. You guys know Lego Worlds is a game where you are like a little Lego man, and it's like No Man's Skycraft. It's like that, but with Lego. But then you have weapons, and you could just go around and murder everything. You can kill everybody. It's fucking brutal. Lego Worlds doesn't fuck around. So that might be a stream worth showing sometime. LEGO Worlds is fucking hardcore. So, again, might be worth showing, but Rice Remelton with $2 Burn the Fur Fox. $2 from Lukewarm Coffee. Once again, left the fandom because of him, by the way. In it for 5 years. Oh, God. Well, I mean, at least you came to your senses. $2 from Hammer Time WC. Bro, you gotta check out Lil Lunchbox on a stream. You know, what kind of Chloe Cleam do you clink this quiz? I'm not gonna take on the Clossy. Come on. Maybe sometime. $5 from Capitan Basara. As another fur fag, I echo the previous fur fag. Also unrelated, check your emails. Trying to send you Lisa the Painful on Steam, Clawmeister. Oh, okay, I'll look into that. Thank you. $2 from Danny Devoid. No, not the Pupperino. Yeah, the Pupperino. I'm sorry. $20 from Bonton Bunny. Just popping in to say hello, Papa Claw. Sorry, I can't stay. I hope this gets archived. Have a good day. Well, you have yourself a good day as well. Have yourself a merry little not raping dogs today. $2 from Killer Queen D4C. Remember, not a bully stream. That's not true. That is not true. Fuck this loser. $10 from Kate Rao Rao. Thank you very much for the great streams. My dad is currently very sick with terminal cancer with 2 months left, and I'm at home taking care of him. These streams have been a really good distraction. Well, thank you for saying that. I'm very sorry to hear that you're in that situation, but I've been there myself, and doesn't exactly get less sad, but I mean, it gets a little easier to deal with, I guess. But you know, here's hoping for the miracle, I guess. Hope you have a good stream, and best of luck. $2 from Artemis, working on D&D and watching this fella. Oh, whoa. This is going to create quite the campaign for you. Let me see. Victor Vinoda with 20 MX. Why commit suicide when there are furries to end? This is the chat. This is the chat members, not me saying this, YouTube. I'm not suggesting violence against furries. I'm just reading chat messages. 25 PLN from Izina 1997. Huh, and I just rewatched Medicare's videos on this. Thanks for talking about this, though, Deadpoint. Yes, very good videos from Medicare. Reminder that Medicare, who talked about Kero and the Zoo Crew before, is not currently allowed on Patreon, and yet Kero the Wolf is allowed on Patreon. How about Thos Beans? How about that shit? So that's pretty fucking scummy. Anyways, I think... Oh, that's good. That's good on Tidal Tempest right now. I think that'll do it for Super Chats for now. We will get back to that in a little bit, but for now, we're going to return to Kero's YouTube channel, and we're going to see some more wonderful things, some more amazing fursuit content. We got misheard lyrics over here, but we can't click on that because it's probably going to be copyright stuff, pet peeves, the joys of fursuiting, Kero 2.0 unboxing, are you living your life, Vine shoutout video, green screen tutorial. Imagine you're looking up green screen tutorials and you find a dog fucker in full fursuit teaching you how to be in how to use a green screen. That would be great. That would be so wonderful. Let's see, The Wolf's Den Episode 2. I guess we should watch The Wolf's Den Episode 1, everybody. Let's check this one out. This seems to be his flagship series. Maybe remove the L from that. But, whenever this page wants to load, that would just be wonderful. Thank you, YouTube. Very cool. Alright, come on. Shitty Jeff Goldblum. Bad streamer. Time for my king cake flavored bleach. Yeah. About time for it. When the fuck is this gonna load? Holy shit. Play my video. God damn it.
The end of Vine.
Let me fucking inject this scum into my veins.
Presidential elections and awesome rewards coming to you.
This channel really gets worse and worse the further back we go. I can't wait to hear him talk about Trump.
Hello and welcome to the very first episode of The Wolf's Den. I'm your host, Kero the Wolf, and let's get...
What is this discount Banjo-Kazooie music in the background?
It started. So I heard the big news. Vine is officially ending. In the
arms of... My dog, fly away!
On October 27th, 2016, Twitter released a statement that they will be discontinuing the popular mobile app because Twitter could no longer afford it and because they cannot compete with their competition, Instagram.
I'm late. Why is he a bad person? Raped his dog until he died of kidney failure. Welcome to the stream.
I'm sad to see it go, but I'm ready to move on. It's what got me started making videos, and I'm glad I got to be part of the Vine experience. I had a lot of memories on that app.
Oh, I'm sure the Vine experience is glad that you were a part of it.
And I'll never forget them. Honestly glad I met all of you guys, because without your support, I wouldn't be here today. Now, I know that the presidential elections have already passed, but I wanted to go and look at a campaign that truly spoke to the American people.
It's about time we elected a fox to run this country instead of a human, because the humans keep messing it up. Here is something.
You mean the weird demonic part?
No, I know that the presidential elections have already passed.
It's fine. Don't worry about the demonic part. It's fine.
I will do as your president. When I'm president, I will make it illegal to woo.
What? Freud ain't the magic.
You know what? I think I jaywalked once, but it's not worth this. How bad can hell actually be if life is like this?
All squeaker toys from cons. I'm sorry. I just can't take it anymore.
Yeah, got you there! I feel the same way as you, Yif Master!
I will build the wall in the proper place, between the bronies and the rest of the world.
If you don't know who that is, that's Majira Strubber.
Build the fucking wall between the dog fuckers and the rest of the world. Also, isn't this Majima guy, isn't he also a dog fucker? I mean, Majira, not Majima. I can't believe I just disrespected Majima like that. God.
Yes. He likes strawberries a lot. I highly suggest you check out his videos because they're pretty funny. A link to his channel is down below in the description, or click right here to see the full video of his Fox president.
He's innocent? Okay.
Now,
well,
a word from our sponsor.
Hello, Flucky Woo from South Africa. You'll get to know me when my suitor arrives.
Oh god, Jay from Red Letter Media. What are you into?
Sweden.
I thought Rich Evans was the sex weirdo, not you!
Anyway, I want you to have a look at a link below for Ferocity Fox. He's an upcoming artist in South Africa, and I would appreciate it if you can support him. Until next time, stay fluffy.
Lastly, Patreon. I love to make the best videos.
Lastly, Patreon. For some reason, I'm still allowed on this platform, even though I fucked a dead fox. I guess that's where Patreon's fucking standards lie. Hey!
Possible, but without funding, it's kinda hard. So I made-
Remember to fund Kero, everybody. Otherwise, it's so difficult for him to bring new dogs back. You know, he's gotta pay for the feed and the lube and everything. It's like, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of stuff.
Patreon to benefit both of us.
Give him a couple bucks a month.
I have tons of rewards from Skype / Google Hangout calls to actually being on my show. There are many
people in chat want me to actually apologize to Majima.
Many different things that you could choose.
Showtime
it! If you want to take a look at it, there will be a link in the description below, or you can just click on my facial region and you will be directed to the website of the Patreon. As always,
I wish we could click on your facial region and be directed to your mugshot. So anyways, there's that video. I don't even know what the fuck that was. It's just another fucking random video that he slapped the title of Wolf's Den Part 1 onto. Let's watch another. Kero Shorts, Wolf in the Woods. I don't drink, but well, I hate to break it to you, fur friend, but it's 11:20 a.m. now, and well, you've fucking driven me to it. Also, can we not have Carl Jobst in the recommended? That'd be good. Thanks. That'd be really good. I like how a lot of the videos we were seeing before in the sidebar, you could see the archive, the Wolf stuff about him, and now for some reason that's not on this one. But we can look at some of the comments, by the way. We haven't been watching though. We haven't been looking at those. Sadly, most of these are from a year ago. What if we sort by new though? Oh, this is sorting by new. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. I don't drink, but...
Hello? My name's Tyler Furlong.
If anything was gonna drive me to it, it would certainly be this chufty motherfucker with a Zootopia poster.
And welcome to this week's video.
Hey, guys. So lately, I've been having what's called an art block. Art block means...
Yeah, no, I like Carl Jobst. I'm saying we don't need to have him recommended on the dog fuckers page. I don't need him ruined for me, too.
I don't know what to do creatively to make content. And, well, there's got to be a way to fix this, right? There's got to be a way. Because I've been stuck, I don't know what to make. And I figured something out, something that's pretty good. A way to fix this is to do an improv video. If you don't know what improv is, it's acting without a script. So today, I thought of an awesome game that we could all play. But today, we're gonna be playing I Don't Drink. Basically, what you gotta do, you gotta start with I don't drink, but...
I don't drink. That sounds like a perfect game for me to pretend to act in. That's perfect.
But, and then you finish your sentence with something crazy. And hopefully after this, I'll get my creative bubble back and doing more scripted videos. So let's get rolling.
See, I feel like there's like a baseline level of craziness that you need to be where you think that like this is, you think that like this still frame right here is like attractive in any way. You know what I mean? Like, I know these people like their fucking fursuits, but this thing is just a haunting, like, its lifelessness is terrifying. I can't imagine being attracted to one of these goddamn things. And I feel like if you are, that's just the most baseline level of crazy that you probably are. I'm sure there's more to it than that.
Ah! No! I spilled my baby. I spilled it. I don't drink, but I think pirates are just trying to teach you the letter R. R. I don't drink, but I think Burger King is the best of kings. But shh, my, it's a conspiracy. They don't want you knowing that he's the actual king. I don't drink, but this cat is so fat. I'm so sorry you're fat. Go away. I don't drink, but I think the guy who got rid of net neutrality is a big butthole.
I don't drink, but kill yourself, please. Not in Minecraft, for real. Please, please kill yourself. I don't even care, Susan. This man rapes dogs. Don't yeet me, yeet him. Kero, kill yourself.
You're a butthole, Jeep.
I don't drink,
that's
but...
how you say your name. I don't drink, but... I think this backdrop is so beautiful. I don't drink, but I think I cried a little bit at the end of Zootopia when Nick became a cop. Oh, it was so beautiful. Don't judge me. I don't drink, but I think having two fursuit heads on is kind of weird. Ooh, wow.
Ah, it's Polly. Wow, my God. Ah, I'm not drunk, but I thought this was ice cream at first, and I was really disappointed.
Do you guys think that this would be a lot better if he wasn't a confirmed dog rapist and roadkill rapist? You guys think that would be better? Like, because I feel like I would still hate myself right now watching this. And I'm pretty sure I would still assume that he fucks dogs. Whether it was proven or not. So, I mean, I don't know. I feel like this wouldn't be a whole bunch better, Anyways.
I found out it was an ice cream. It was still good though, eh? The entire thing, see? Oh my God. I don't drink, but I think I could be a pop star. Oh! I'm sorry for the puns. They're kind of popping, you know? Oh, God.
Oh, yeah, just like you were popping your dog's cherry. That's right.
I went to the store the other day, that's really funny. Popping by. Well, no, I saw this girl. And she said, yo, I met Billy Ray Cyrus. I'm like, you lime. Yeah, because it's Coke lime.
This is just like that time he popped his nut inside that dead fox.
Coke lime, you liming. I don't drink, but I think you're pretty good at puns. I don't drink, but if you fall on your face, you shouldn't fall on your face. I'm not drunk, but I think I give good life advice. Why would you smack your head off a wall? Don't do that anymore. If you're dabbing outside of an airplane, why are you outside of an airplane? You'll go flying and die. Did you know?
If you're on the outside of an airplane, hopefully somebody fucking kicked you out of the airplane and you'll go flying and die.
Nuts are made out of real nuts. If you fall down the stairs while trying to kick a hobo, that's your own dang fault. Why are you kicking hobos? Good life advice. Wow. Ah, I'm the box. You hate me, you don't do it. Ah, I really go for a Pepsi right now, you know. I mean, it's all good. I want it on my ear. There we go. No, don't fall. Yay, I did it. I don't drink, but I'm a little dizzy right now. I don't drink. But his boxing glove is the best of all gloves. It's huge. I mean, look at it. It's a big glove, and I like this glove.
Cephos!
Ow! It reminds me of a
Lusik!
It's okay, baby. All right,
I'm sorry. Whee!
I dropped the baby. I don't drink, but I sometimes like colors. There we go. I like colors. I can't turn it. Here we go. Colors are cool, you know. I mean, they're pretty great. I can't breathe.
You guys think this is worse comedy than Control Alt Delete? What do you mean? You have a problem with the fact that there's still like almost half a video left? Well, I'm gonna do y'all a solid, chat. I'm gonna save myself from jumping out my own window, and I'm gonna stop that video. But sadly, we're not stopping the stream yet, because how to talk to people on the internet? Well, we know, Kero, we know so well about your experience talking to people on the internet. How old does your dog have to be before he's ready for anal? Kero, did you ever get an answer on that? I'm wondering, because I'm wondering how friendly and helpful the members of BeastForum.com were when you asked them how old your dog needed to be when you could have anal sex with him. I'm wondering how old. I mean, I'm wondering how friendly they were, you know? I'm wondering about that. So, you know, Kero, masterful individual, very knowledgeable when it comes to talking to people on the internet, as we've seen. So let's watch.
Hello? My name is Tyler Furlong, and welcome to this week's video.
Hey guys, so you might be wondering why the ugly sweater? That's not the question. The question is, why are you wearing an ugly sweater? But we're not here for ugly sweaters, are we? My name is Kero the Wolf, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to talk to people on the internet in 5 easy steps. Because a lot of you guys have no idea what you're doing. This is what your average furry message looks like. Hi. How are you? This message that you see before usually gets ignored by the person that's viewing it, or gets them angry with the passion of a thousand suns.
Remember, everybody, Orange Man bad.
You know, I'm going to say right now, I don't care what your politics are. I am 99% sure Donald Trump's never had his penis inside of an animal. So therefore, he's a better human being than you, Kero. I'm sorry. I'm gonna take that hard stance. I know that's gonna divide people, but yeah, I'm sorry, Kero. Gotta go with Orange Man on this one.
So let's start off with step one. Say something that catches their interest. For example, you could say, "Hey, I like your fur pattern. What was the inspiration behind your design?"
99%. I'm leaving that 1% chance open. Because you can never be too sure. Especially in Washington. But anyway.
See, that's a great question. Or you could say something absolutely crazy. Taco Bell's a lie. Sand is the new makeup. This squid is Obama. But usually that does...
It's just so random, guys. It's just so incredibly random. Don't you love how incredibly random this man is who fucks his dog until it has kidney problems and dies? Don't you love how incredibly random that is? The thing that I love the most is how the death of his pet probably didn't even fucking stop him. We know he's into fucking roadkill. Maybe his dog died and he was just like, time for the good fucking. We don't know. We don't know, Kero. We don't know how depraved you get.
Doesn't really
fucker.
Don't do that. That just freaks people out. The point is to connect with them so you can start having a good conversation. This is how you start. Okay, this is the starting point. Step two, find something that they're interested in just in case you fail terribly.
You know, John, you might be a hardline communist, and I might be the leader of a domestic terrorist group based out of Montana, but I feel like we could find some real middle ground. Some equal footing on our love of raping hippos.
If the conversation is dying down a bit and the person isn't really saying much, bring something up that they might enjoy. Anything from a zesty Taco Bell burrito to their hobbies. This usually keeps the other person interested in the conversation. If you don't know their hobbies, just ask. Just like, hey, what are your favorite hobbies? I'm kind of interested. But one of the most important things is step three. Don't be freaking annoying. If they don't respond at first, wait. Freaking annoying. One of the most important things is step three. Don't be freaking annoying. If they don't respond, is step three. Don't be freaking annoying. One of the most important things is step three. Don't be freaking annoying.
All right. So thank you for the lesson, Kero. Yeah, I appreciate the lesson.
If they don't respond at first, wait. Just wait. Don't spam them with messages. That's just mean and it's annoying. Don't do that. That's a guaranteed way of getting blocked. On my experience, anyway.
Don't spam them with messages if they don't respond to your first picture of the dead dog's anus. Just don't keep swarming them with it, okay? Maybe they're at work. Maybe they're busy fucking their own roadkill, you know? People have lives, okay? Don't get on their fucking case, okay? You whore!
Whoops! Step four, be respectful. Oh my god, no way! Oh my god, that's fabulous! Jeez! I mean, really. This is obvious. I don't have to explain this one. I have no words. This is obvious. Be respectful. Be nice. And finally, step five. Wow, we made it without imploding. Awesome. Now this step is the most important step. This is
finally got a 3-star cougar in Red Dead Redemption 2. Well, I mean, send her my way, but also don't fuck her. I mean, wait. Hang on.
This is where you guys mostly up. Don't send them anything weird. Don't proclaim your love for them. Don't send them anything lewd.
Don't send them anything weird, guys! You really wouldn't want to send your new friends anything too weird. That would be wrong. Anything too weird and you might get blocked, you know? You don't want to be too weird. That would be bad. Thanks, Carol, for the advice.
Nothing screams blocked like a dick in the face.
So don't do that.
Jeez. Oh my God. The amount of times people have just started their conversation with a dick pic. Don't do that. Jesus. Oh my God. Now hopefully you will have better conversations on the internet with my 5 tips. Well, anyway, I just hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to hit that like button and hit the bell so you...
Don't you love how almost half of the video is this stupid fucking asshole begging for likes?
Can get notifications.
We are like 3 minutes. We're not even 3.5 minutes into a 5-minute and 20-second video, and this fucking scumbag is already asking for fucking likes and subscriptions. Fuck you, asshole.
When I post. Anyway, I have a Patreon with a lot of awesome rewards. If you want to check it out, click down below in the links. It will definitely be down there. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to give the video a big thumbs up. If you disliked it, give it a thumbs down. But I mean, who gives thumbs down anymore?
What if I want to report you for being a dog rapist? What if I want to do that? Is there a way that I can do that? Can I do that? Is that an option? Hang on. Let me just hang on. Oh, I need to sign in. What a shame. Oh, if only I was signed in, I might be able to report him for being a dog rapist. Anyways. So, Kero Shorts, Wolf in the Woods. Did we see that one? I think this might be the connect, like the full version of all of those. Because there was multiple parts. I don't know. Let's check this one out. Actually, fuck this one. I've changed my mind. This one sucks. It only has less than 10,000 views. We're going to go to the most popular videos, everyone. What's the most pop? Well, we saw this one. And this just turned into me bullying Shane Dawson. Let's check out Fursuiters Trolling on Omegle, Episode 2, featuring Majima Strawberry and Mark Husky. Okay, good. This whole stream is a real kick in the dick.
The following preview has been approved for all audiences.
Apparently your ability to record words was not approved for yourself.
Oh my God! Oh God, dick! Dick!
Man, why is it that every time I drink, I wind up wanting to play Dark Souls 3? Fuck me.
Okay.
I know you on the far right. I know you.
No, you don't.
Strawberry. Yes, I do.
Well, now I know a lot more about.
I feel like if you went on Omegle and you randomly connected to this gaggle of dog fuckers, that would probably be worse than someone just jerking his cock at you. I feel like that's worse. It's a little bit worse.
That I wanted to know.
I am on Furry SL. Is that like a drug?
Second life.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not familiar with furry networks.
Is that furry ecstasy?
Does this make me look a little husky?
God, Jesus.
I hope my mom doesn't find this video.
I would like to just say I don't know anything about Majira Strawberry. Maybe he's alright. He's a bit of a fucking... I don't know. I saw his segment in that other video and it was a bit bad, but I mean, if he's at least you know what, all I fucking ask is for people to publicly fucking shame and come out against Carol. It's all I'm asking is for people to publicly shame him. If you were friends with him, fine. Maybe you didn't know that side of him. That's fine. People get duped by people all the fucking time. I've been that way. That's fine. You just need to be able to say, yeah, fuck him, fuck everything he does, Fuck everything he stands for. Fuck all the people that still support him. Fuck anybody that's ever put their goddamn genitals inside a goddamn animal or anywhere fucking close to an animal. Like, that's all I need. If you want to be a furry, if you want to have a fucking fursuit, I don't give a shit. Fucker, we live in a world with coronavirus. We're all gonna die soon anyways. Fucking who cares? But if you're gonna be, like, harboring some guy with a furry... or with, like, a dog fucking fetish, you just need to... You just need to leave as well. You need to walk off of the face of the planet and not look back. Because that's the fucking line. You want to be a furry? Fine. You want to be a fursuiter? Perfectly. Okay, not perfectly okay. I mean, I'm still going to make fun of you. But it's whatever. It's fine in the grand scheme of things. But all that really matters, if you're a friend of Kero's, if you're anybody related to anybody like this, just don't do the thing where you, like, sweep it under the rug because, oh, well, it would hurt the fandom. We don't want to talk about all the dog fuckers in the fandom because it would hurt the fandom. Because I know there's so many of you fucking people out there that do that shit. And it's like, no, you're the ones that are hurting the goddamn fandom. Do you want your fucking people to stop being a joke on the goddamn internet? You might want to stop harboring the fucking dog rapists. But again... I don't know anything about this Majira guy. Majira, I don't know how to say it. I don't know anything about this guy. Maybe he came out against Kero. All I'm saying is that's all you need to do. Fucking make a stand. Make it fucking known that you don't support this shit and that you're willing to, like, do anything you can to put these people in jail. Because that's the thing is Archive the Wolf, one of the people that is in my Discord, helped me with this Kero stuff. And does a lot of zoo sadism updates. Archive the Wolf. Furry individual. And I don't hate Ark. Because Ark makes a goddamn concerted effort to give me all of the fucking proof that I need to call this person a goddamn sex weirdo. Do we need proof? Do we need to see the fucking proof again? Do we need the goddamn proof? Because I can show the proof. I can show all the fucking... I can do this all day. I can do this all fucking day, man. The point is, not all furries, yes, but all I'm saying is, let's go on a bit of a tangent about this Majira guy, because I know some people in chat are saying, he's alright, he's not a bad person. I don't know, but all I'm saying is, in my opinion, if you're a friend of Kero the Wolf's, what it takes to be no longer a bad person is to fucking commit your life to, like, stopping people like this. I don't know, maybe that's asking too much, but, I don't know, man.
Oh.
Oh my god.
Hi.
Shut the...
Jose over there was looking for some 13-year-olds and he came across 5 fucking weirdo furries. Never mind, it's 3. I'm just drunk.
Where'd you go?
What is happening?
What?
What? The
holy crap, the main attraction is Majira.
Okay.
Majira, you are my favorite.
Oh boy, I'm so glad for the copyright claim. I wanna kill you myself.
What is it?
One day, I'm confessing this. One day I had cherry lemonade.
How could this? Oh my god, you fuckers, make a joke that isn't copyrighted. Ah.
Boys.
You're one of us.
You're totally one of us.
I need to find the missing sombrero.
You'll enjoy it, I promise.
You'll really enjoy it.
What started the rant? The rant was started because some people, because I was making the odd joke about the dude in red in the bottom left there, the dude in the red fursuit. I was making the odd joke about him. And people in chat were saying that he's not a bad person, he's an okay guy, he's somewhat okay in the furry community. I don't know, man. I'm gonna say right now, again, I know this sounds extreme, but this is just my opinion. And in my opinion, if you're friends with Kero, you're guilty until proven innocent. That's just my opinion. Because we know enough about his friends at this point that you're guilty until you're proven innocent. And so people in chat were saying that he's an alright guy, and I was basically just saying that, like, you know, if you want to be considered, in my opinion, if you want to be considered an okay furry, all you need to do is just actively work against people like this. I don't know, report them when you see their accounts. There's people, again, a couple of months ago, I did the stream about Cepheus Rivendell, or Rivendare, or whatever the fuck his name was. The dude who fucked a deer in the Zeus Adis group. The dude who three puppies dies on his cock. Winky face. And he still has his fucking fur affinity page. All of these people, Kero's still on fucking Patreon. Kero still has his YouTube channel. And it's like, people still support these fuckers. So I don't know, man. I guess I'm just on high alert at this point. I feel bad to an extent, because I know there are some furries who aren't horrible people. They're perfectly fine people who legitimately just like the art. And that's fine to an extent. It's just, I hope you know that a lot of those artists probably like fucking dogs.
It's ridiculous.
Oh, yeah, daddy.
Oh, really?
He calls you daddy.
I'm a daddy. I'm so happy.
You made it in the real world.
Do I get a hug for being a daddy?
Yeah.
Oh, I knew it.
I'm so proud of you.
Who's the child? Who's the child?
I'm the child.
How you doing?
I love your mustache.
Bye! That guy looked, you know, this guy here, hang on, let's get him. This guy here, I can just imagine being this guy. You're like, you're having some fun with friends or whatever. You're like, fine, let's go on Omegle. What the fuck year is it? 2016? 6 years after anybody fucking used Omegle? Sure, let's try it. Maybe there will be some fucking weirdos. And then you come across these fucking weirdos. This guy probably thought it was like a troll. He probably thought this was like, oh god, this is great. This is wonderful. And then he just immediately disconnects.
He didn't like you.
That guy looked like just a little bit too much of a normie.
I like your hair. Oh, that bitch.
We weren't good enough for him to masturbate to.
No, we weren't.
I'm as kinky as you make it.
Ooh. Oh, really?
Okay, dude. Are you famous?
Are we famous?
No.
Yeah, we're famous. He's famous, actually.
Yeah, little girl, I'm super famous. Oh, wow.
He's famous.
Who are you?
He was on Nickelodeon.
I remember in puns. That was really bad.
Bird.
That was so bad.
This guy's straight from 4chan.
Yeah.
Hang on, what was that? Okay. This fucking rave lord over here. Now this man is the savior of the stream. Get a load of this guy. He's got his glasses. He's got his lights. He doesn't give a shit.
A plus.
Fuck you! You don't clap at it! I was clapping at it! Fuck you, you dog fucker!
I am a furry. I am a fag. I got shagged by my cat's dad. He was furry. He got his hair in my eye. So I
got shagged by my cat's dad. Wrong species, but you're close. You're close.
Smash him, send him to ISIS.
Hello, furries. Welcome to my den.
Don't die, I mean, yeah, don't die. Oh, God, he's looking. Oh, I can't.
I'll use my nose.
Whoa, that is so cool.
You're sorry Aiden Paladin has to see this degeneracy? What kind of simp are you? Aiden Paladin has seen enough degeneracy to fucking fill a book. This is just a drop in the bucket of degeneracy.
What?
Anyway, here's Chocolate Rain. That's enough of this fucking video. Jesus Christ, this was bad. Okay. We're gonna do like a couple more, I think. I think we're gonna round down the stream in a little bit, but I wanna do a couple more first. I don't wanna watch any more fucking Omegle. By the way, that video was like less than 5 minutes long. And it feels longer than my fucking childhood, so that's saying something. Let's watch another one. Kero unboxing. No, let's do Mursuiters. Fine. I've got nothing left to live for. Let's do Mursuiters. Whatever. Why is my Switch all the way over there? I want to play something and not have to think about this. Also, note that this is the only video where there's like an almost negative dislike ratio. Let's see some of the... Oh, the comments are turned... What a little bitch, Kero! You're such a fucking little bitch! You're willing to rape a fucking dog until it dies of fucking kidney failure, but you can't keep your fucking video comments on because they might call you out for what you did, you little fucking cunt.
And welcome to this week's video. I hope you enjoy.
Oh, look, everybody. He's got the fucking Guy Fawkes mask. He's making memes from out of 2007. Let's all make fucking... I hate this man. I hate this man. At least fucking care. At least Snake Thing didn't have a YouTube channel. I didn't have to see Snake Thing talk. I didn't have to see Snake Thing try to be funny. Oh my god, can you imagine if Snake Thing had a YouTube channel? That would be the worst fucking thing in the world. Holy shit. But at least this guy doesn't. At least this fucking guy has one. Alright, I'm a little bit drunk now. But anyways. Fuck this guy.
Hi guys, my name is Kira the Wolf, and this is my first Character Steals video. I always wanted to do this. Don't worry, I'll still do fursuit videos, but I like this too! Plus, it's nice to have...
Guys, he's stealing my shtick, that suck fucker.
Because sometimes, I can't always record videos. Ah! Now if you're looking at the title, yes, I am going there! Hold me back! Hold me back! No one's there! Oh well, I'm going! Warning, this video will cover...
What is this video about? Oh yeah, Mursuiters. Oh yeah, okay. It's okay, Kero. This won't even fucking top the list of the things that you've done that are disgusting. It's fine. I think we're prepared.
Topic. Viewer discretion is advised.
Yeah, we wouldn't want to be under 18 for this fucking video from a guy who rapes his dog. That would be bad. Wouldn't want that.
So, if you don't know what mursuits are, then you're in luck, because I'm gonna tell you. A mursuit is a suit that has holes in it.
You can successfully do the sex.
Though they're not super common in the fandom.
Successfully do the sex. Thank you, Kero. Very cool.
We're gonna talk about them, because why not? So why am I bringing this up? Well, it's come to my attention, well actually I knew for a while, that the fandom likes to witch hunt people. You know, witch hunting, you cast a spell and you go blah blah blah.
Please don't ever show me that frame again, you disgusting fucking weirdo.
JK.
By the way, everybody, everyone gangstil to everybody fucking gangstil till the goddamn zoophile crosses his arms.
Witch hunting people is basically harassing a...
Guys, let me tell you the right opinion to have.
...person online and getting as many people to harass that one person as possible. It could be for the most stupidest thing ever. You like hubba bubba gum instead of juicy fruit? How dare you, sir? Witch hunt! But this is one thing that I see over and over.
You like to rape your dog instead of raping goldfish? How dare you, sir? Die of AIDS, you fuck!
People put mursuiters on blast all the time. Heck, I have a few friends who received death threats. Death threats for having consensual adult sex in their own hotel room with mersuits on.
Maybe it wasn't the fucking mersuits. Maybe it was the pets they brought into that consensual hotel room.
Really? Really? Boy, I'm about to go Super Saiyan because this shit is over 9,000. I have nothing against mersuiters. Hey, sex is fun. If you want...
Over 9,000. Funny meme.
I want to wear carpet and sweat a lot, then go right ahead. I'm just saying. But back to the point. Why should it matter to you what people are doing in their own private time with each other? They're not hurting anybody, they're just having fun. I see furries beware pages everywhere on Instagram, Tumblr, and, well, everywhere, that put these suitors in a negative spotlight in front of a large audience, making them look like monsters. People find out their personal information and post it there. No, why? And then these people get bullied to the point they want to kill themselves. Are you guys proud of yourselves? Making a person feel so bad about themselves that they just want to leave the Phantom or even...
Yes, I'm pretty proud of myself. When you've been fucking outed as a dog fucker and a person who rapes his fucking dog until he's got kidney problems, and you fuck roadkill too. I don't know, Kero. I'm feeling pretty fucking proud of myself right now, Kero. Let me just go ahead real quick and show the fucking evidence again. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's good. That's the good beans. That's what we need real quick here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. When can you have anal sex with the dog, Kero? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You probably want to know, don't you, Kero? Oh, well, guess what, buddy? Guess what, buddy? I got your fucking answer for you, you fuck. Boy, I'm pretty drunk. The point is this guy rapes his dog, so it's fine. It's fine. Fuck this guy, and fuck everything he stands for. Fuck any of his friends who are still his friends and are still supporting this fucking guy. The fucking proof is out there. I would like to make another point to just say that while I have not shown that many materials on the stream today, many of them do exist. I decided a lot of them are not that relevant. Some of them I just forgot to save, admittedly, and that's my bad, fully, but some things, there's a lot more proof than what I've shown you already that this man is, at the very least, surrounded by a lot of people who fuck dogs and children. At the very absolute least, this man fucks... This man is friends with someone who fucks children and has been arrested and fucking sentenced to 25 years in prison for fucking children. At the very least, he was friends with Snake Thing. Anything more than that is, well, not exactly fucking, not exactly speculation, not exactly accusation. Once again, might I show... There are fucking, in fact, records of all of this. All of this has records. And it's so easy to say, well, yeah, but he didn't actually send these messages. These were fake. It was another guy sending them. Oh, it's fine. It's fine, guys. All those fucking pictures. All those chat logs of him sending dead fox pictures to his fucking zoophile pedophile friends. They were all just fine. Don't worry. They're fine. They weren't him. They were the Iranian super hackers, everybody. It definitely wasn't Kero. I don't know. I'm going on tangents now because I know that there's still people who like to think that this guy is fucking innocent. And I whittled this down to the only evidence that I feel is really needed. And it proves enough. It doesn't necessarily prove everything. Again, what were the pictures? They're all like hex codes. Hard to tell. Yeah, this one. And this one. Yeah. Once again, I guess if you're just joining us,
I will talk about this. This, again, I showed this at the beginning, but this is a picture posted on his Fur Affinity, on Kero's Fur Affinity. And you can see this if we zoom in here. This is from Kero Yamimura, I think it says. It's a little bit small to read here, but yeah, that's his puppy. And meanwhile, if we go to fucking these pictures. Oh my god, let me pick the pictures. If we go to fucking these pictures, we've got the same picture. ThumbnailBeastForum.com. ThumbnailBeastForum.com. As far as I'm concerned, that's all the proof that I need. There is so much more proof that Kero has done what people have claimed that he has done. And I guess I'm just going off a little bit because I fucking know that there's going to be those people who come into the comments later who are like, oh no, bro, but he's fine. He didn't do the thing. You're just witch hunting. Blah, blah, blah. This is cancel culture. Blah, blah, blah. As far as I'm concerned, I have all the proof I need. I have all the proof I need to go in full fucking bully mode. I have all the fucking proof I need to expose you as a sex weirdo, Kero. Or Joshua Hoffman, or whatever the fuck your name is. I have all the proof I fucking need. And if you want more proof, I can fucking give it to you. But it's not necessary at this point in time. I guess that's just all I have to say about that. Because I know there will be people who will be like, oh, but there's no proof, you're just witch hunting. And it's like, no, fucker, there's proof. And if you're willing to deny the proof, then that just raises further questions about yourself.
Harm themselves? God, why? Heck, this even happened to me. I'm not personally a mercenary, I don't engage in that activity, so I definitely know how it feels. I took a suggestive-ish picture in my suit. It wasn't meant to be seen by the public, it was just gonna be sent to some friends for a joke. But it got leaked on an Instagram page with over 30,000 followers. Before I knew it, everyone was commenting on my post that I was a mercenary and that I should die because I apparently was a mercenary. So, great, but like, Jesus, guys.
No, Kero, you shouldn't die because you're a mercenary. You should die because you raped your dog until it had kidney problems and died of natural causes because of your cock. That's probably why you should die.
Stop.
Because of your cock.
It's getting to the point where it's getting really bad. You shouldn't be telling people to kill themselves for having sex. I mean, I didn't have sex in my suit, but Jesus.
Yeah, I don't know, Kero. I feel like if you have sex with roadkill, that might change the situation a little bit. I feel like if it's a fucking dead animal, that might make me want to change, you know, my skin, my planet, my entire fucking life. But it might also make me change my opinion about whether or not it's okay for me to, for people to criticize you for having sex. That's such a good way of putting it. I'm sure you'll get people on your side who don't realize that you're talking about fucking animals.
Jesus, stop. Yes, there is a part of the fandom that does involve sexual activity, but that's not what the fandom's about. But it's also not bad. People make mercenaries out to be the bad people who are ruining the fandom. But it's not them who are ruining the fandom. It's the people who want to baby-proof every aspect of this community. By lying about the fandom to the people, you're only digging us in a deeper hole that we can't crawl out of. The truth is that the fandom does have a sexual side to it. Is it directly the main point of the fandom? No, it's just a part of it. Look at other communities. The anime fandom is way worse than us.
Man, Pyrocynical really went downhill after fucking that roadkill, says chat member. Alright, I think that about does it. There's more to this video. There's more to his channel. There's a lot more to see. And reminder again, and I wonder if I have this open still. I don't. This'll probably take a fucking second to load, even though I've loaded already, but reminder again. Your boy is on Patreon. Your boy is still available on Patreon. You can still donate to him. You can still join his fucking Discord. You can still fucking recommend him videos to make every month if you fucking feel like it, because he has a $50 tier. You can give this man who fucked his dog to death a $50 a month fucking bonus. if you so goddamn feel like it, and Patreon is fine with it. Holy goddamn shit, my internet, would you load this page, you fucking slut? Holy shit. How long does it take? What is even happening? Who the fuck is torrenting so much gay porn in my neighborhood that they've got... It's fine. It's fine. It'll load on its own time. But the point is, there, you know... The point is, Kero the Wolf is creating YouTube videos, everyone. And he's got 6 levels of membership on his Patreon. And you too can be privy to his fucking recent posts and all of his Photoshops and his Hey Guys and his Team Rocket dub video. He's making special content for his patrons. Reminder, as we end the stream, that Patreon is super fucking okay with allowing this degenerate dog rapist on their platform, but apparently Mr. Medicare is just a little bit too much of a wrong thinker for them. Reminder. Just a brief fucking reminder of all of the other goddamn people who got kicked off of Patreon because they have apparently the wrong opinions or some shit. But apparently Kero the Wolf is just trucking along. He's just fine. Nobody cares about the dude who fucking raped his dog till he died of kidney failure. That's cool. That's perfectly okay. All right, everybody. That'll do it for the stream. I'm going to be reading some super chats to end us off here. But before I do, hang on. Castle. You scum. Oh, you. Would you just. Oh, you fucking scum. You fucking scum. Castle. Pick up the thing. There you go. There you go. I just wanted to get some music going here. We got the music going. We're gonna do, yeah. Hang on. Gotta get the volume right. And then we can get this underway. Yeah, that's good. Very nice. Alright, let's see. $5 from Matt G. Corona Bernie Virus. $5.39 from Kramer. I live in the only state in the US where owning zoo porn is illegal. It makes me happy that no one can legally bring that shizzle to my state. Hey, what state is that, bro? We might all need to fucking move there soon enough. $5 from Grimmy. Ow, the edgy, messed up weirdos you cover made me realize I'm not as messed up in the head as some of these special snowflakes. Special snowflakes, you know, exceptional individuals, whatever you feel like calling them, honestly. Let's see. $5 from Foxy-esque. Hey, Claw, yay, a stream. What's this one about? Oh. Frowny face, lol. Yeah, it's one of those, but it's okay. It's mostly just as terrible YouTube videos. Not too much of the gory details, I guess you could say. $2 from Daijobu. $100 Patreon reward. Roadkill threesome. Oh boy. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't put it past him. $2 from Joshua Cluely. Hans Getzi Flammenhofer. Very important. $5 from Foxy-esque. I'm home with the flu, not the virus one, and I got all excited for your stream. And, well, love you, Claw Bear. Well, I love you too, and I hope that you don't, hope that your flu doesn't get any worse than it is. Happy painting and God bless, I guess. Hope you had a good stream. $15 from Some Cookie. Here you go, Claw Daddy. Thank you, Some Cookie. Thank you again for having that awesome Guts Berserk avatar. I'm really into that. I'm really into that, so thank you. And, you know, I hope you had a good one. $5 from Rilla? Riley? I'm not sure how to say that. Yo, Clawjima, I hope I'm not too late for the trash fire. No, don't worry. This was an ongoing trash fire, I assure you. It only got worse once I got drunk. $2 from Mothy Eagle. What are the chances this guy owns another dog? I'm not sure. I feel like if he did, he would have... he's either kept very quiet about it or he doesn't, I would say. But, you know, I don't really know how Kero is now. Maybe Kero's totally repentant for the things that he's done. I don't know if that makes it better that he's done those things or acceptable that he's done those things. But, I mean, if he can, like, commit himself to never doing it again, maybe there's something to be said for that. I don't know. But I kind of doubt it. Still doesn't seem like he really fucking fully wants to admit what he's done. On his YouTube, at least. $2 from Tiana H. Thank you for your content. It's how I'm surviving college. You're welcome. $5 from I Hate Yankees. Yiffin heck for feller. Yes, I agree. $5 from Aaron Beaulieu. I knew Kero didn't do it, and this overly dramatic video of him saying platitudes over stock videos debunks all of the evidence against him. Oh, it totally does, dude. Totally fucking does. He's sorry, okay? $2 from Foxy Esk. I'm gonna have some vodka if that's cool. Man, I got my chocolate whiskey right here, and by the way, I'm getting fucking sick of these chocolate whiskeys. They were good at first, but now I'm like, ugh. It's time to drink some proper booze sometime soon. But fuck it, drunk at noon. Why not? $2 from Totally Not Connor. Chuffy yikes, my dude. The stuff's gross. Sure is. I'm not wrong about that. Chuffy yikes. $10 from Katie Eats Cats. Which is an unsettling name, considering this stream. Katie Eats Cats. I can't watch this right now, but Lord knows I'll be forcing my boyfriend to watch you later with me. I love you, Claw Papa. X3 nuzzles, pounces on you. Ooh, woo, you, so warm. Sparkly heart, stoked to hear this later. Kill yourself. Thank you very much. Hope you had a good stream. But moving along, $2 from Izuna. Huge yikes. I'm glad Snake Thing is in prison, though. Yeah, reminder that at the very least, the least you can accuse Kero the Wolf of is being pretty good friends with Snake Thing, the recently convicted pedophile, the 25 years in prison pedophile. Fuck you, Snake Thing. Hope you die soon. I hope they make it slow. £2 from Emperor Bots. You are of the homosexual variety. Well, I wasn't aware of that, but, I mean, I'll take your word for it. You'd probably know better than me. $2 from Capitan Basara. Mundane Matt still has the worst unboxing video. I don't think it could be worse than DSP's unboxing video where he fucking doesn't unbox the thing. And there's a fire alarm in the background the entire time. I don't think it could be worse than that. $5 from Totally Not Connor. Claw, when you get your play button, can you sob on video like Matthew Jihadi Jarbo? I mean, possibly it could happen. I am known as an emotional bitch. £5 from Chewy. Hey, DeadwingDork. First time I've been able to super chat. Just wanted to say we appreciate you and hope you keep up the good work. Well, we the DeadwingDork collective appreciate you as well, and I hope you had a good stream. £2 from John Smith. Can't see his face, but I know it's very punchable. Oh, have we not seen his face? Oh yeah, it's fine. Reminder that this is a fucking bully stream through and goddamn through. And if you want to make fun of this soy-filled bitch tits motherfucker, you can probably do that. This fucking guy looks like Aaron Hansen got left in the goddamn cold over the fucking winter. This fucking guy looks like the fucking distended, bloated corpse of that dog he raped. Alright, that's good. That's enough of that. Anyways, let's see. $10 from Blonde Maverick. The lack of remorse for his actions belies a distinct apathetic mentality towards the poor creatures he supposes to be infatuated by. What a sociopath. Yeah, there is that level to it where it's like it's easy to say that he's better than a person like Snake Thing or Wolf or Cepheus or really any number of those people in that group that he was in. He's certainly not the worst member of that group, but I feel like it's... He claims that he's like some kind of fan of animals. He's a furry. Apparently he likes animals, you know, and yet it's like he's willing to do this shit to animals. I don't know, man. I just... It's sociopathy 101. That's what it is. $5 from Capitan Basra. Bro, I'm gonna be real with you. I'm from the hemisphere that likes size ridiculous dongs and breasts. I didn't even know who this was until this all popped off. I mean, that's fair. That's understandable. But, you know, now you know. The more you know. 10 PLN from Izina 1997. Can we get Kero to Persona 3 himself? Yeah, I mean, that might be a good outcome for everybody involved. £5 from Chewy. With how Shane snorts, you could imagine him being a gay pig persona, not a bully super chat. Oh my god, guys, am I crying right now? Oh my god. $20 from Ian Terpenning. No message, but thank you very much, Ian. I hope you enjoyed your stream. $10 from Punished GSM. The only way to be a good furry is to not be a massive public degenerate and keep it to yourself. And for the love of God, don't do it with your pets. That's wrong with you. This kind of trails off in the end. But I get what you're going for. And yeah, I agree. $10 Russian, it says, from Zoo Furry, from Sabat, sorry. $10 from Sabat. Zoo furries should be hunt for sport. Quite the opinion. Can't say I disagree. £5 from Job Richardson. Imagine if a hunter mistook him for a wolf and shot him. That would be bad. Ha 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 ha. Really bad. Ha 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 ha. Yeah, it would sure suck if somebody accidentally shot him in a hunting accident. $10 from... Oh, we gotta scroll back up. Oh boy. $10 from Sabat. Once again, I hope they game end Kero in jail. That is some more spicy opinions right there. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that on YouTube, but you know what? Fuck it! This guy raped his dog to death! Fucking die, asshole! $5 from Reese's Pieces to the tune of Maneater. Whoa, here he comes! Watch out, dogs, he'll chew you up! Whoa, here he comes! He's a dog humper! Thank you. Very cool. Very cool. Thank you. $5 from Dragon Strunk. Hey, Claw Man. Longtime watcher, first time simp.
Simp!
This guy's a confirmed simp. No, I'm just kidding. Thanks for making my library shifts interesting. You're welcome. I sure hope nobody hears what you're listening to. $5 from Mr. Skittles Maniac 1. Just tuned in, and this wolf man is slurring his words worse than when you're drunk. And who would have any idea what that's like? I've not been drunk on a stream recently. That's not happened. I'm definitely not drunk now. €2 from Doki Doki Cub. I will never draw furry art ever again. Well, your name is Doki Doki Cub, so I don't know, man. I don't know, man. You know, cubs are basically just children, but they're also furries. You realize that doesn't make that okay? Yeah. Anyways. But, Hijilimaru IV with $2. What is this song?
And that would have been at 11:05. That would have been one of the Sonic CD songs. Probably Stardust Speedway B-Mix, or maybe Quartz Quadrant, Wacky Workbench, one of those. One of the Japanese Sonic CD soundtrack songs. Sorry, I can't be more specific. $5 from Vibe Raccoon. This whole stream can be described as a rut-row moment. Yeah, that moment when you get caught in your caught fucking balls deep inside Scrappy Doo. I mean, I guess it's Scrappy Doo. Nobody would really care, but I mean, even still. $35 from Mexican Link 1986. You have earned my simp Mooney. I mean, you don't need to simp for me. You just need to... I mean, if you want to give me money, that's fine. You don't need to call yourself a simp, though. That's rude. You're not a simp. You're as free to leave and hate me after this stream as anybody else. But I appreciate that you've chosen to give me some dollars. That's very nice of you. Thank you. $5 from Mew Ichigo. The eyes are done by making a chamber under the mask to give the illusion that they're always looking at you. They do this with paintings and haunted houses. Okay. So they actually are kind of always looking at you. That's freaky. $5 from Mosey Burns. Shekels for you. Appreciate you, Clock King. Thank you very much. I appreciate you as well. And I hope that you enjoyed the stream as much as you could have, considering these circumstances. $5 from Blue Satoshi. If you listen carefully, they sample "I Got the Power" around the start to start a Speedway Bad Future. Hang on, do they? Hold on. I'm not hearing it, but I'll believe you. I will believe you. It fits. $5 from Kenta. Inject the zoo cringe straight into my eyes, Clawdaddy. You got it. 20 SEK from T-Don Uraja. We need a furry exterminatus crusade. You said it, not me. $5 from Wolf Wizard. As a wolf and a wizard and a woman, I say burn this sex pest. Always glad to tag along on these weird internet field trips with you, Deadwing. Well, you know, there you go. That's again, you can be as much of a weirdo, degenerate, furry scum as you want. But, no, I'm just kidding. But you can be you can be as furry as you want as long as you're willing to make a very definitive public stance against people like Kero. That's the only thing that really matters, in my opinion. $3 from Duke Hate. The people demand "This Is Fine" merch. No, this is fine. This is totally fine. Don't worry about it, guys. Kero the Wolf is still on fucking Patreon, everybody. But this is fine. This is totally okay. You can go to Patreon right now and donate $50 per month to Kero the Wolf. But that's fine. This is fine. Yeah, I can see why you might want "This Is Fine" merch. That actually makes sense. £5 from Pilenifel. Bit difficult to say. Pilenifel was groomed by furries when I was 13. They were the ones who showed me my first porn. I just with it was an anthro furry. I'm still scarred. I'm sorry to hear that. That sounds very unfortunate. All I can say is, at least you seem to have turned out better than Carol. That's the only thing that matters. Your morality is somewhere above Carol's, so that's the important thing to remember. $2 from _ lewd the lollies, not the puppers. No, that's not better. That is not better. You can stop with that. $2 from Spiky Belmont. Looking forward to Tails Gets Trolled on Yakuza. It might happen sometime, but don't hold me to it. I mean, it might happen. $5 from Fateful Wings. People like this are why God doesn't love us anymore. What the heck is up with Patreon standards and letting this awful person stay on? Yeah, I don't know, man. I guess it's fine. I guess he's just okay. As long as he doesn't have wrong opinions about, like, politics or whatever insignificant shit. Like Mr. Medicare.
You know, it's fine if you fuck your dog, I guess. Thanks, Patreon. Very cool. $5 from ZZZZZZ. I like your litmus test, but would start beating the person for showing me animal torture. My cat died yesterday. I watched him die. Couldn't take it. Oh, I'm very sorry for that. I've been in a similar situation before. Not with a cat, but with a person. And, yeah, it's very unfortunate to hear. I'm sorry about that, sir. Or ma'am. But, I hope you were able to find some solace in the stream. $2 from Seba Hill. Help! He's begging for help, but I still don't know if help has come, you know? $2 from Alyssa Richardson. Earth is the 10th circle of hell. Below Cocytus. I don't know how to say that. Cocytus? Cocytus? I don't know how to say that. $5 from Gluck the Walrus. Clawdaddy, make it stop. Man, you're the one who clicked on this stream. Don't blame me. $5 from Rila, or Riley. I'm not sure how to say that name still. Every dollar spent here is money further away from the sex weirdos. I mean, I'm a sex weirdo, but not for dogs or children, you know? Like, I'm willing to acknowledge that I'm a tiny bit of a sex weirdo, but at least I don't fuck dogs and kids. That's the important... At least I only focus on the willing. Anyways, so... $2 from Alyssa Richardson. Amp Lemon better not show up in any sidebar. Oh, boy. Somebody was talking shit about Amp Lemon earlier because I was talking shit about Gus Johnson. And I guess they just did that. But no, I don't know. I like Amp Lemon. He's great. He's one of my favorite YouTubers. $5 from Banach. Finally caught one of these streams on my day off. Now that it's 11:20, it's time to drink heavily and get mad at sex weirdos. Thank you, Clawfather. Well, you know, I don't mean to influence all of you to start drinking. I'm just making it a little easier for myself. But, I mean, I hope you had a good one way or the other. $50 from Weasel Snarts. Hey, I enjoy your content. Thanks for looking into the cringe. I'm too weak to read. Me and my fiance really enjoy your streams. Also, quick question. You refer to playing video games a lot, and I was wondering how you pull that off with one hand. Well, it's the one hand on the right of the controller. And then it's sort of like my elbow, I guess you could say, because my left arm ends at about my elbow. It's sort of like my... I still have full range of like elbow movement, but yeah, it ends about there. So it's kind of like my elbow using the left stick and the L button and stuff like that. I usually use L2, like the left trigger or whatever. I usually use that by like moving it into my leg or something like that. So I mean, it's a bit of a makeshift situation. In the case of like motion controls, that certainly provides a bit more of a problem. I've actually been thinking about buying a VR set recently, but unfortunately so many of them are like two-handed by default. Thankfully, Half-Life Alyx is one-handed, so I mean, I might be able to play that at the very least. But yeah, a lot of VR is like two-handed, kind of sucks. Little too hard to just sort of, you know, trick my way around like with the Wii or whatever, but you know. It works, more or less. I'm able to play enough games that I like. I started playing Anime Souls last night. And I was pretty stupid, but I liked it. So, you know, it works out. $5 from JoJo Queen. Oh, and thank you very much, Weasel Snarts. $50 from that. I appreciate that very much. And I hope that this stream was... I hope that you don't feel like you got ripped off by giving me that. Because... this has been a pretty bad stream, but I mean, you know, it's a Kero the Wolf stream. It's about as you might expect. But $5 from JoJo Queen. Dude reminds me of Doug Walker in that he thinks he's so funny he had no self-awareness. Does yiffing dogs do something to your brain cells? I'm not sure, but we might want to talk to Doug Walker about that. 200SEK from Ryan Holtz. I know you often ask why furries are like this aren't rejected by the furries, and the reality is that there is no ultimate community arbiter, but folks like this make themselves unwelcome in just about every individual group. I mean, I guess that's fair. I'm sure most groups are willing to cast out. Like, if I were to join a Discord furry group right now, I feel like if I said that I wanted to fuck dogs, they would probably kick me out pretty quick. But I also, sadly, feel like a lot of people are into the furry thing for the same reason as, you know, as, like, Kero or whatever. Like, they would probably contact me. Before I got banned from the Discord, I would probably get contacted by people going, "Hey, bro, me too." You know what I mean? And it's like, I don't know. It's not all of your faults, because I feel like it's just two different groups. It's like the people who are legitimately just into, like, the art and the what have you. And then there's the people who actually are just there to fuck their dogs or their cats or whatever they have. And I feel like they probably are using the furry thing as sort of like a means to an end in terms of acceptance socially. But yeah, it's not fair to the non-offending, non-sex weirdo furries, which I know is hard for some people on my chat to buy, non-sex weirdo furry, but yes, it's kind of true, in some cases. $2 from Spike. Did he hurt that puppy by raping it? Burn him. Yeah, I think he did. The dog sadly, unfortunately, died of kidney failure, and I can assume that might have been related to Kero's cock. So, you know, that is indeed very sad, Kero, what you did to your dog. $5 from Yaya does slap. Stop bullying this furry. Oh, whoa, he didn't do nothing. Thank you. $2 from Zeth Chavez. We should send Blade to go after Kero. Why would Blade be able to do anything? What is he going to wave his rotting leg in Kero's direction? I think that might just make Kero hard for whatever reason. $2 from Mr. Skittles Maniac 1. Message retracted. I don't know what you said, but it must have been too spicy for YouTube. $5 from Yaya does a slap. Bro, every furry I've met is hung as fuck. Like, massive, thick schlongs. So sexy. All right. Thank you. $2 from John Calder. Moofin oh whoa in chat is trying to claim Kero is innocent. I mean, did I not show you the fucking... Did I not show you enough of the goddamn proof? Okay. Well, I don't have it... I don't have it fucking set up yet, but... Man, scroll through the fucking stream. I showed you enough shit to prove that your stan is problematic. Your fave is problematic, bro. $2 from Alyssa Richardson. Sangi intensifies. That's right. That is correct. Feed those. Lusik. All right, that's good. That's enough of that. Oh God. $2 from Foxy Esque. It's okay, Mr. Claw. I'm a little drunk too. Well, you know, that makes us even at least. $2 from Meeb. Is it noon at least yet, Claw Daddy? You're pretty drunk. Well, you're 3 minutes off from noon. Don't you blame me for... Anyways, you're right, though. You are right. 2000W with two lines through it. Because I am a fully grown Canadian and I don't know what currencies are. From 2000 with two, W with two lines through it from T. Kim. Anime people make dakimakuras, not animal sacrifice. That's right. $2 from Johnny Johnston. Please drink some water, Clawfather. Don't worry, I'm gonna be fine. Not as bad as I was on that other sex weirdo stream. $2 from Nicholas Davis Maher. Timmy's is doing a digital roll up the rim. Hashtag WooFlu. Oh yeah, bro. I'm gonna win my Tim Hortons Ford Fairlander or whatever the fuck the car is called, and I'm gonna go on a coronavirus journey around the country where I'm immune but nobody else is, because haha, fuck you. $2 from £2 from underscore underscore message retracted.
Sounds like it was an exciting one. $2 from Foxy. Ask if you're sick of chocolate whiskey, try caramel vodka. I've seen that. Butterscotch vodka. Looks pretty good. Might try it. $5 from Katie Eats Cats. Got a good giggle out of hearing you say the furry copy pasta. Oh, thanks. Also, it's a lesbian joke from 2013 Xbox Live. Well, that's fine then. I mean, that sounds like it's only slightly degenerate and only in the good way. I mean, what? $2 from C. Gaspacho. Shane talks like that guy who drank the gay potion. Oh my god, Tay, I drank the gay potion. Oh my god, I just feel so good right now. Can I touch you, Jay? I drank the gay potion. $5 from Sabat. Sorry for the enraged super chats earlier. The things this people do to make me really pissed. Now it's understandable. This one went from fucking bully stream to the edge of the goddamn universe. I have said some shit about this guy, and I don't take any of it back. $5 from Rat Queen. Every time I think I beat alcoholism, a sex weirdo string flings me right back in. Man, I haven't drank for like 5 days, and this was the one that did it. It wasn't even the sex weirdo stuff that did it. It was the fucking fursuit videos. It was the goddamn YouTube channel. It was the worst thing. $2 from Deplorabology. You really an amputee? How did it happen? Just curious. I was just born incorrectly. That's not the most interesting of stories, but sometimes you can just be born wrong. If you really try hard enough, you can be born without any limbs. It's great. Well, at least without one of your limbs. $10 from Capitan Basara. Went for a long walk listening to this whole stream. Here's some funds for a new... And it got cut off by the fucking... By the fucking YouTube thing. A new lava lamp, Clomity. Have a good day, man. And hit me back about that game, you butthole. Lol. I will check my email later, sir. And thank you. I hope you had a good... Hope you had a good walk and a good stream, but... that will about do it for the Kero the Wolf sex weirdo stream. Again, this has been an officially sanctioned bully stream. This guy can go fuck himself. This guy has been... Again, I think that I've proven well enough that this man is guilty of what people say that he is guilty of. If not everything, then at least guilty of fucking enough to warrant the bully stream. But if you don't think that I'm right... There are mountains of evidence out there for me to contradict you with. If you wish to start problems in the fucking chat, in the comments about, well, excuse me, but Kero, sorry, no. But I have enough to. I think I have enough evidence that it would convince a jury of his peers, let alone the stream, let alone the law. That's just my opinion, though. Anyways, take care, ladies and gentlemen. Let the Castlevania music wash over you. See ya. Penis.
Three puppies dies on my cock.